He knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Okay, guys, so this is the kind of question that a lot of undergraduates are going to see in your Organic 1 or Organic 2 classes, and this is a retrosynthetic analysis problem. So a very common kind of question is going to give you a molecule like this and say, build this from some given starting material. So I'm telling you, we want to build this compound from alcohols of 5 or fewer carbons. So if this seems confusing, you're going to want to go ahead and watch my tutorial on retrosynthetic analysis. Okay, so whenever we're doing retrosynthetic analysis, we want to ask ourselves two questions. Number one, what kind of molecule am I trying to make? And number two, what kind of reactions do I know that make those kinds of molecules? So looking at the target molecule, this is an alcohol. And so we want to go through our database of reactions and say, what reactions do I know that make alcohols? Now, if we're in an Organic 1 course or maybe an Organic 2 course, we know that Grignard reactions make alcohols. So a Grignard reaction is going to be a very good approach because, number one, it forms alcohols, and it also makes new carbon-carbon bonds. So it takes takes small molecules and combines them, right? So when we think retrosynthetically, we're going to pull apart this molecule in ways that make sense because we will know reactions that will put them together in the way that we just pulled them apart. So when we do a Grignard reaction, we know that the nucleophilic carbon, the carbon that is attached to magnesium, is always going to form a new sigma bond with a carbonyl carbon. And the carbonyl carbon, right, the carbonyl becomes an oxyanion, which is protonated. And so what we understand is that any bond that is stemming from the carbon that was the carbonyl carbon can have been the bond that was formed. In other words, this carbon right here was the carbonyl carbon, right? Because the carbon that was the carbonyl carbon will remain attached to that oxygen atom. And so that means that either of these two bonds can have been a bond that was formed in a Grignard reaction. And so let's again look at our restraints though. In order to choose the correct bond, that means we can either fragment here or here. But if we fragment here, we have a 2-carbon fragment and then a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6-carbon fragment. But we said that we need alcohols of 5 or fewer carbons. So this is going to make it a lot easier on ourselves if we do this. So that's where we're going to break this molecule apart. And if we go retrosynthetically, remember that this kind of fat arrow is a retrosynthetic arrow. It does not mean a reaction, it means back in time. And so what can have come from this is that, and we had got the MGBR, and that. So we have these two compounds, and this is a valid retrosynthetic step because if we combine these compounds, we will get that, right? And so now we still have more to do because we said we need to be starting from alcohols. Well, where did these in turn come from? Well, this can have come from an alcohol, right? This retrosynthetic step is valid. And remember that this does not imply a reduction. What this means is a reverse oxidation. This is back in time. This is valid because we know that if we have this propanol, if we oxidize it with, say, PCC, we can get that aldehyde. And then from here, we know that this can have come from the alkyl bromide, which can in turn have come from the alcohol. These, again, are valid retrosynthetic steps because there is some reaction that we know that will induce the transformation in the forward direction, right? So this, so now we have our starting material, right? This is a 5-carbon alcohol. This is a 3-carbon alcohol. So these meet the criteria that we stated about valid starting materials. So now that we have the valid starting materials, let's just discuss in the forward direction what needs to happen so that we can prove to ourselves that this is a valid synthetic pathway. So let's first take our propanol there. Here's our propanol. We know that if we use PCC, right, PCC is the way to get an aldehyde from an alcohol, from a primary alcohol. So we just did the forward direction of this retrosynthetic step. Now let's also build up this fragment. So let's take our 5-carbon alcohol. We know that if we use PBr3, we can turn an alcohol into an alkyl bromide. And then we also know that if we use magnesium in ether, we can turn that into a Grignard reagent. Right? And then now we know if we take this guy and this guy and combine them and then do some acidic workup, we will get our product because this carbon would attack that carbon, which would make this bond that we initially broke apart in the first step of the retrosynthetic analysis. So once again, to summarize, the key is to look at what kind of molecule we are making, in this case an alcohol, and then think, what kind of reactions do I know that make alcohols? In this case, Grignard was our choice. Pull the parent molecule, or you know, pull the target molecule apart in a way that makes sense, because we know of a reaction that will put it back together, and then go backwards until we have starting material that meets the criteria of the problem. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.